Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. And today I'm going to cover off some of the new additions to the Mission Editor in the recent 2.5.6 Open Beta update. I know it's been a while since I've been able to upload a video, but I've been a little bit busy if you've been keeping up with current affairs, which I'll explain more towards the end of the video. So let's get started. Right, so here's the changelog from the 15th of July, and I'll highlight the elements that we're going to cover off in the video. So first of all, we have introduced the historical mission editor mode filter, and I'll run through that in a little bit more detail. We also have the ability now to copy and paste trigger zones, and I'll run through that. And also we have mission editor triggers added condition, unit type in zone, aircraft, helicopter, ground, naval. So they're the topics that we're going to cover in the video today. So let's get started. Right, so let's start with the first of those items, which is the historical mode. And basically, what you need to do first is set up the date, as I have here for this particular mission, 17th of June 1944. Now what we do is we click on the clock at the bottom, which says historical list of units. So I'll click on that. What I'll do is I will go to ground units, select my country as USA, and then go into the armor section. And as you can see, it will only list the elements that were available to me in 1944, which means it gets rid of all the modern units, which kind of simplifies my life a little bit now that I'm concentrating on the World War II missions. The unfortunate part for me on this is obviously the aircraft set that we have in DCS for the Warbirds. They are all during 1944, essentially. So if I try and select an aircraft, let's do that. We'll go to aircraft, and we'll list those for the USA, and they're all here. But because I set it to 1944, they're all there. Now what happens if I want to set a scenario like 1943? So we'll change the date there. We'll make that 1943. Save it. Go back to the aircraft. And then let's list the aircraft. And as you can see, the list starts to reduce. If I then set a mission in 1942. And save that. And then go into the aircraft. We'll select UK, and as you can see, there is only the Spitfire now, and none of the American aircraft actually appear in the listing. So from an aircraft perspective, if I want to make a mission from 1942, then I would turn the stopwatch off, and then I will get a complete listing. So if I then go to the USA, and I'll get a complete listing of all the aircraft. But for ground units, it's absolutely perfect. And that's basically how you use the stopwatch. Or, more to the point, the historical mode within the mission editor. Now, it's only linked to units. As far as I'm aware, it's not linked to loadouts. But then again, it is in its early infancy and early access for this particular mode. Whether that's coming moving forward, like for the modern guys, I don't know. So there we go. That's the historical mode in the mission editor. This time we'll take a look at the copying and pasting of the trigger zones. Very, very simple. What I've done here is a sort of a bombing raid. P-47 will come in as a lone wolf. When it gets to this point, it will play a sound recording saying steady, steady, bombs away. And what I've got here is I've got a bombing zone scenario. And what I want to do is I want to copy that and paste it down the length of this runway. Now the only thing with the copy and paste of the actual trigger zone is it copies the zone only and nothing related to any of these triggers. So you still have to add the triggers to it, but it simplifies the whole process. Because if I want multiple trigger zones, all of the same size, this is a very, very simple way to do it. So it's another godsend in the mission editor and mission builder's arsenal. So what we do is we click on the first one, which is Bomb Runway KPK. We press Control and C. We move off that, move the mouse pointer to where we want it, and press Control V. And again, Control V. And again, Control V. And it's that simple. And then what we can do is we can set up in the triggers and actions, various actions for that. And as you can see, I had already set up the KPK bombed event with a bombing zone. And now I've got multiple zones of that. So what I will do is I will select the OR function and we will clone this, move it down, and we'll say KPK 1, clone, KPK 2, clone, KPK 3. And we'll stick the OR functions in there like that, so that when there's one AN/M57 bomb in one of these zones, it will play this sound.
This is Whiplash. Good job. Thanks for the support. You may depart.
And it's as simple as that. Now, one thing I will point out, particularly for the World War II situation, is I had to load up a P-47D with AN/M/M57s. Unfortunately, the AN/M-64s do not appear in the list. The 65 does, but the 64 doesn't. So please, ED, if you could add that to the bombing zone functionality, that would be great, because it impacts the A-20G and the B-17. We can't use the bombing zone functionality for either of those aircraft, which is a little bit disappointing. But if you could add it, that would be grand. Thank you. So what we'll do now is we will go into mission and I will show you how that worked. Okay, so here we are in mission now. So let's see what happens. There we have it. So as you can see, it's a complete bonus to be able to copy and paste various trigger zones of the same size or differing sizes if you want. So let's move on to the next subject. Okay, so the next topic is now the part of coalition in zone improvement, which now incorporates additional elements, which is quite useful really, because at the end of the day, if you don't want to assign a specific unit in a zone, etc., etc., and you want to differentiate between ground units, naval units, air units, you can do it with this particular trigger. So let me show you how that works. What I've got here is a Kubelwagen. It's got a waypoint scenario here, and it will enter this trigger zone called Kubelwagen. But it's also got an aircraft in it. Now, if I was to use part of coalition and in zone historically, then that would trigger the action automatically, because there's a red aircraft in there. With this particular version and the change, I can now make it so that it's not triggered until that ground vehicle gets into the zone. So how have I set that up? Let's go into here. It's basically a one-time action, and I've called it ground units red. So I've said when part of the coalition is in zone, it also works for part of coalition out of zone. I've said it's the red coalition. I said the zone is Kubelwagen. And here's the change. I can select either an aeroplane, a helicopter, a naval unit, or a ground unit, or all of them. And what I've done is I've selected ground. Now what will happen is, as soon as that Kubelwagen gets into that zone, then it will play this particular message.
Well done. Mission objectives achieved.
And it's as simple as that. So let's go into sim and find out how well it works. Okay, in sim, here we are. The Kubelwagen is wending its merry way to that particular location there.
Well done. Mission objective.
And there we have it. That's how it works, and it works particularly well. So go ahead and try that in your mission builds. Now, I did promise you guys an update as to what's been happening. And if you're not already aware, I'm currently working with Eagle Dynamics to produce World War II Warbird mission content. And that's what's happening moving forward. That's the reason why there's been a bit of a slowdown in the provision of videos on the channel. So that's the update. I carried out an interview with Phil Stiles towards the end of July, and that's up on his YouTube channel. So if you'd like to go and watch that, then you're more than welcome. But again, thanks for watching. And if you like, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. I hope you found it useful. And subscribe if you'd like to. Thanks again. I'll catch you later. Ciao for now.